Hi, everybody, and welcome to Daytona International Speedway, the world center of racing. It is the start of the 2013 GEICO Motorcycle AMA Pro Road Racing season. And this, of course, is the Vance Hines Harley-Davidson Racing Series opening round, the only race other than the Daytona 200 that will have but one round here. But, boy, is this going to be interesting. But what sets the stage, I think, for this year is how it ended last year. Let's go to the season finale at NOLA, New Orleans Motorsports Park. Out of the last turn, watch that.
Well, you can see right here is Tyler O'Hara and Michael Barnes coming to the line. They're going to come out here, and Tyler's going to reach over and grab Barney's arm. Barney kind of gets out of the throttle, gets really upset. Tyler beats him to the line, but after the official took a look at it, they reverted the finishing order, and it cost Tyler O'Hara a lot of money and a lot of positions. But Michael Barnes went on, and now he gets to run that number one plate this year on that bike.
First time in over 20 years that he won a championship. And not only did that cost Tyler O'Hara second place, it cost him second in the points. As he got penalized bad enough, he finished third in the points. We have a great story, though, on the inside pole position for this race coming up. And our pole sitter is with Greg White.
For Rochester, New York's Travis Wyman, his first pole position in the Harley-Davidson sports class. Now, Travis, this is Daytona, all right? Are you expecting to get away here, or are you understanding that this could be a 10-rider dogfight all the way to the checkered flag?
I definitely have an understanding that it could be a big group of us up front, but I mean, the plan is to break away here and see what I can do. I know I got a lot more left in me as far as lap times are concerned, and hopefully I can get a good start here and see what I can do with it.
That sounds like he's got a little bit of the pre-Daytona nerves that he's working on here. And obviously, Scott Russell, great to have you with us here again. You've spent enough time at Daytona, and as much success as you've had here, you look up at that big banking and you realize you're ready to go racing. It's butterfly time.
It kind of is. I mean, I was never, didn't never get the butterflies, luckily for me. But for Travis right now, it's hard to say what he's feeling right now, but he knows he's got a hungry field behind him. We've seen some epic racing from this class throughout the last couple of years, and Steve Rapp's back in this class this year, number five, sitting right next to him, and he's got to watch out for that, and his brother out there on the outside of row one, Kyle Wyman, we know how good he is here. So he's got his hands full right now, and he's going to try to get through turn one clean and then try to see what happens after that.
And the 45 of Benjamin Carlson finished second in the points last year after that flip-flop with Tyler O'Hara, and interestingly, points champion Mike Barnes sits with that number one plate now, but he's back in the second row, and it just goes to show you how intense this class is. And these bikes on these banks with the draft, it's going to be amazing.
Yeah, I watched some of the qualifying yesterday, and there were a big packs of riders running around together, and I suspect that's what we're going to see from the front runners here. It's really difficult to make a break here, Greg, especially with the draft and how well it works. Even if you get a decent gap, you know, you got a couple of bikes working behind you, they're able to run you down. So I expect a barn burner of a race here today.
I think so, too. We've got also, keep in mind, we got Bobby Fong here, and he's qualified in the sixth spot. He's going to be running this year. Shane Narbonne, who was a front runner last year, sits back in 12th. So there's some guys that have some work to do, but certainly capable of it. Folks, I'll tell you, we are in for a great race. One of the reasons is the weather. Yesterday, Scott, very cool here. It produced a lot of incidents amongst many of the classes, but today it's looking pretty nice.
That's right. Finally, the weather's working out for us right now. It's nice and warm out there. The Dunlop tires are working well. Had a lot less incidents this morning leading up to today's race, and I suspect it's going to be serious stuff out there, and a lot of these riders out here pulling double duty too, Greg. A lot of them running the 600, the DSB class, and having to jump back from a 600 to a Harley is a big difference in the riding style and the way that motorcycle acts. So it was going to be interesting to see who comes out on top of this one today.
Where do you want to be when you get to the end of the race here? I would think not leading coming out of the bus stop.
Well, I said that last year, and a couple of races were won from the front, which is hard, very hard to do here. In the past, my idea, if I was racing with somebody else, is obviously to be second or in that pack, not the guy leading out of the chicane, because you're kind of a sitting duck for the most part. But like I said, last year I was proven wrong a couple of times, so I'm not going to go out there on that limb again.
Smart man. Minimize the risks. Always
right.
Minimize the risks.
That's right.
These bikes aren't really designed for racing, so that presents some interesting challenges too in terms of the chassis, doesn't it?
It does. I mean, they like to wobble around and move around. They've made some big strides in the handling department of these motorcycles over the years. They've gone to a polyurethane rear engine mount, swing arm area. And when I rode the thing here a few years ago, it had a rubber mount, and the thing never stopped wobbling from the chicane all the way to turn one. So it made it quite interesting. Like I said, and you're going to see a lot of movement out of these motorcycles. They've got those high handlebars. They've got no wind, no fairing on the front to block the wind. So any little movement input into that handlebar sets those things off. So I suspect you're going to see some wobbling around right here, but these guys, they don't mind. They leave it wide open. They're going to go for it.
It's fitting we got flat track racing happening here, because you see some of these guys will actually let go of that left hand and grab the fork.
That's right. With no fairing, no wind protection on the front of these motorcycles, they're going to try to get as small as they can, get those arm, that left arm down out of the wind, and try to get under the paint of that thing and just be as slim, streamlined as they can be.
How about the launch here, obviously? What gets these bikes off of the line well?
Well, you know, they're tractors, these things. So they could almost start without even opening the throttle. You could just let the clutch out, and it's going to go. So, I mean, but this is an important part. And the trick about Daytona is these riders never get to practice turn one from the pit road. So every time we start a race here, just keep that in mind, none of these riders have practiced that all week. So it's going to be interesting. It makes turn one a quite a bit tighter corner. So it can get pretty hairball down in there.
And the last thing we want to mention before the start is right before this session, we had a Daytona sport bike lose an engine going into one. They've done a great job of trying to clean it up, but these guys are going to be hitting that first time at some serious pace. I'm sure everybody's been well informed about it, and they'll be ready for it, but it's going to make it interesting. We are about ready to go. Grid is set. Front row ready to go, and it is Wyman, Rapp, Carlson, and Kyle Wyman. That's your lineup. Pretty even off of that front row. Let's see what happens. Travis Wyman looks to the inside. That inside looks like it might pay off, but a nice move. Is that 45 Carlson? No, look at that move. That's the number 5, Steve Rapp. Savvy Steve Rapp, the experienced veteran, trying to get it done down the inside.
That's the thing about this class. You leave the door up just a little bit, somebody, I guarantee, is going to walk through it. And that's what Steve did. He saw an opening on the inside. Now he's got control of this race. First time through the International Horseshoe right here. You got to be cool on the first lap. Get these tires up to temperature. So these guys have kind of got to walk on eggshells for about a lap, and then they'll start pulling the trigger on this thing. But Rapp, he doesn't seem to be bothered by it at all.
Not at all. And the 45 up, Benji Carlson was able to get a good launch. Slots into second, then pole sitter Wyman. And behind him, looks like it might still be his brother here. Good battle shaping up for that third spot. But Rapp wasting no time.
Bobby Fong's made up a couple of spots right off the bat. He's moved from 6th up to 4th on the 50 right there.
Oh,
dive
yeah,
in there behind the 24 right there. And here they go up on the banking for the first time right here. And this is one of the most important corners on the track, Greg. You want to get a good drive out of that to get as much speed as you can. And two riders are already pulling away a little bit.
And clearly right now we are seeing the 45 of Carlson going, I don't want to lose Rapp. And these two, as you said, are starting to check out over the rest. Look at Fong. Look at the toe he's getting. And down the outside, and he's passed. We have a new leader. Carlson moves in front of Rapp as well. The draft on that long back straight down into the chicane and out of here down into turn one is huge.
That was Kyle Wyman on the 33 getting that good draft down the back straightaway. He's our winner from last year. He knows how to get it done. This kid's super fast. Last thing he wants is his brother to beat him out here. I guarantee you that too. So it's going to be on between those guys.
Well, I would think, you know, they say your most intense competitor is your teammate, but when you got a brother racing as well, that ups the ante even more. Look at these draft moves. And again, it's just that tuck, as you pointed out, no fairing. The air is not managed very well, and they're punching big holes. And Kyle Wyman all the way from back and forth into the lead. It looks like Fong taking a look at Travis Wyman for second.
And you can see this white stripe that they're running across. That's the oil drive that the workers had to do a great job to clean up that oil spill. Big racing going on in one down here.
That was a huge run. Gage McAllister started 11th and is swept up into the lead, and that was all draft aided in those two big runs here on the banking. But now big move down to the inside. Now can he keep it pinned down tight? Fong trying. McAllister not quite able to keep it tucked enough. Fong leads.
Well, McAllister, I'm not sure we were expecting to see him up here like that. And I don't know if he was either, but he's up there now. And he's going to get a good look at Bobby Fong as he runs through the infield kink right there as they break hard for that west horseshoe, tipping these things in, tipping it in nice and slow. And get that thing turned and get a good drive out. It looks like Fong's got that, headed down into turn 6 right now. And they're going to make that second run up across the west bank.
Oh, and the 5 of Rapp is done. Left part of your screen in the split screen. Rapp has pulled off and is walking it back into pit lane. tough early day for a very experienced competitor.
Well, thank God for Steve Rapp. He picked up a ride on the Dame Westby GEICO Honda for the Daytona 200, so his weekend doesn't end here. Like we're seeing him walk away, we'll see him again out here this weekend.
Tough to see something end that early. You can see him shaking his head, a little bit of frustration there, but the battling on the track is continuing to be intense. Look at this run here. Kyle Wyman was up there, but once again, Fong able to work that draft. Carlson slots, well, he had it. Now it is 51 McAllister right back up into that third spot.
Well, now you're going to see in the fourth spot right there, Tyler O'Hara, the guy we saw in that clip from last year at NOLA. So he's going to try to redeem himself here at Daytona and try to just outrun these guys. He's making a good run. Carlson drops down on the low side. He's got a run, but you can see how equal these motorcycles are. The emphasis here is on the rider.
Well, that inside move, he had that double draft, and Carlson's going to go right by. The question is, can he get McAllister? Doesn't look like it. And O'Hara on the outside shoulder. It's going to sweep through and way on the outside, benefiting from about a three-wide draft comes the number 15 of Michael Corbino and into the lead. Boy, you can be outside of the top eight in this and make that move.
I told you it's going to be hard to break away in this class. And look at this race, man. This is 10, 12 bikes tied together. This is what this Harley class is all about right here. This is the emphasis on the rider who can get the suspension set just right, who can pick the best lines, and who can draft the best and be in the right spot at the right time.
And here's a question. When you get that huge draft-aided run, you got to slow these big, heavy bikes down, too. What's the brake scenario like for
these guys? Well, I'll tell you, it's intense. I can just imagine slinging a 550-pound motorcycle off into turn one right there. And when you're in the draft, you're passing your normal brake marker. It's hard to see where you'd normally want to brake. Basically, you're just waiting until everybody else brakes, and then you do it a little bit later. So Corbino was able to do, pull a nice move and hold that, and he's got a little lead as they go up on six again.
And look at second place is the 14 of Steve Crevier from 13th on the grid out of Maple Ridge, Canada, that Motorsports Plus bike, and he got a great run and was able to follow Corbino, but Corbino is actually gapping him a little bit here. We'll see what unfolds as they head down into the chicane, but he has got himself, that's the biggest margin we've seen.
Wow, and he stayed up high quite a ways. Now he's going to drop down all these riders, get that slingshot effect as they run down the back straightaway. It's going to be a big breaking duel as they get down to the chicane right here, and it gets tight. I tell you what, when you're down on the inside, you got to make it stick or you'll take the whole field out right here. Easily done. And this is a slick part of the racetrack. We've seen a lot of incidents over the weekend here.
Corbino hanging on to the lead, but that margin was more than half by that strong run. And I think that is our defending champion. Mike Barnes has come from way back and now has slotted into second. And here the draft show begins again. And when they get side by side like that, it's not a one bike draft. You're punching much bigger holes. Everybody behind benefits.
That's correct. And now you're going to see a lot of that. Look at this. Five, six guys wide as they come down. Here's it going to be down the inside on the, is the 14 right there.
Man, he is tight to the inside, Crevier, and through. And as we say that, he's swamped around the outside by a group of people. Was that 33 Wyman back into the mix?
That's right. That's exactly who it was. This is a real crapshoot here today. And so far, everybody's kept it really clean. I mean, they've run really close along that banking, and it so easily could get into another rider. So far, all these riders done a great job of keeping it clean up there.
And this is a true sprint. We're already past halfway. And there's no let up. You've got to stay after it. And a great run by Kyle Wyman. 45, Carlson in second, and 14. It may be the story here. That's Corbino. Check that. That's Crevier up from, as I said, 13th on the grid, right into the mix for the podium. But he's got Bobby Fong hunting, and Tyler O'Hara is not far adrift.
Well, these right here, Greg, are the hardest races to win. When you've got 10 guys right here, it's hard to place yourself in the exact right spot as we're going to make that run to the start-finish line here in a few laps. So you want to try to keep yourself toward the front of the pack. See, if you get shuffled to the back, it can be hard to make it up to the front. But right now, we've seen some serious slingshot drafting going on, and you're seeing it again right now is Carlson, I think, down around the outside of Wyman as they go down the back straight.
And the guy that's going to benefit is 14 Crevier. They get side by side, as we talked about. He makes it work. But look at the 51 of McAllister again, able to make a couple of moves, slot right back up into fourth, and start the challenge. He got around both the 33 of Wyman, check that, the 15 of Corbino and Carlson.
Well, you can see this is down low. They're going to run. Last time through the banking down there, Greg, you remember they were running the high line.
Yeah.
So basically, it's where's the front guy going? We got to follow him. We want that draft, and that's what you're seeing right here.
And heading into the tri-oval, it's 45. Your leader, Carlson, for a moment. There comes the 33 once again of Kyle Wyman, but he's down too low. He's getting no help, but he is literally getting freight trained here. Tyler O'Hara, and make the move. Sweet move right there once again down to the inside. Just some fantastic racing.
It looks to me like Carlson may have an issue. He's, he's working his way right from the front to the back of that group right now, but out front, there's always somebody ready to take over that spot. Here he goes, diving down into the infield. Horseshoe, first time.
And I think that's the 50 of Fong.
Fong's back up front.
O'Hara slotting into second. He's got serious company. The 14 of Crevier. They slip back. Corbino in the mix. 33 Wyman. No, 14 now. Crevier, nice move. Picks up that third spot. 15 Corbino, now fourth.
That last time by Tommy, Bobby Fong ran a 206.1. That's less than a tenth of a second off the pole position. So he's really got his head down right now. Going to try to make a break with three to go, about two and a half actually to go, as they make that run up on the bank. And you'll see this lead disappear by the time they get to the chicane.
Boy, he immediately dropped low, trying to take the short way around.
And it might pay off on this bike. You know, when you consider right here, just in the tri-oval alone, the low line opposed to the outer line up around the top is 120 feet different. So think about that huge banking as they run around there, and you'll see that lead disappeared in a hurry, didn't it?
Yeah. Well, he got onto the banking in first. He, for a moment there, was fifth. So that's how quick it will change up. Crevier really putting on, I think, a spectacular show from where he started. Obviously, whatever the issue was, if they had one on the bike, if it was simply a setup change, they nailed it.
Yeah, they did. I mean, you know, when you're sometimes in qualifying too, it's hard to get good laps out there by yourself. And now when you see the pack, all you got to do sometimes is see how it's done, and then you just follow and you're able to stay with them. And that's what you're seeing. That's what brings these guys together like that. They're all hungry as well. Everybody wants to win this one at Daytona.
Look at that. Five abreast heading down. Oh, wow.
Man.
That is craziness. And it's Wyman back in front. And Crevier, though, he got past, then he counterpunched, dropped down to the inside, picked the lead up, but only for an instant. And the 45 of Carlson right back up into the point.
Maybe he was doing a little test, you know. What happens if I work to the back? Can I get back to the front? Now he knows he can. So Benny's out there going to school, testing it, looks like. That's a smart move by a rider like that. So that's what you want to do. You're kind of, it's just a dress rehearsal to the last lap. That's all this stuff is, really.
And that's coming up quick here. We are two to go and less than that at this stage. Carlson leading over Crevier, Fong, the 33 of Kyle Wyman, and the 29 of O'Hara, your top five for the moment.
For the moment, and like I said, they've kept it clean to this point. But when they come across the line this time, there's only going to be one more, and it could change the attitude of this race. You're going to see a lot of guys get super aggressive, and no telling what's going to happen.
Out of turn six and up onto the banking. As we said, it was Carlson on point, but he didn't get a great run off there, and he is already under full attack from Crevier.
Pretty cool. Looking at the time, scroll across the top, you see Narbonne in 10th runs a 205.9. That's faster than Paul. All these guys are tied so tightly together. It's pretty amazing, this racing.
Kyle Wyman way on the left. He's got that arc in, and he makes it work. Slots into the lead. Fong right back into second.
So this is where it gets pretty serious. Everybody's going to want to try to position themselves and get as close to the front as they can, as they make their way down to the infield again, because you got two more shots after that to get it right, and you don't want to drift too far to the back, I'm thinking.
And for the first time since the first lap, I think our pole sitter, Travis Wyman, moves to the lead.
Yep, Michael Barnes has made his way back up there, moves up into fifth right now on that number one. That changes right away.
White flag coming out, one lap to go. Briefly, Benjamin Carlson back in it. Yeah, it looks like he's going to probably have the line down into turn one. He'll lead starting this last lap. Fong trying the big sweep around the outside and hangs on to second. Not good enough for the point.
It's going to get kind of crazy now. Here we go, down into the horseshoe again for the last time. Carlson hard on the brakes down in there, leads him in there. Michael Barnes, as I showed him in fifth, he dropped to the back of the pack right there. Let's see him on the number one. Let's see what the reigning champ's got in the bag, if he's going to pull something out.
And you talked about Shane Narbonne's wicked quick lap.
Yes.
Folks, he's fifth.
He's fifth. So he was a winner from New Jersey last year, his first race win on the Harley. So it's good to see him running again up here in the lead pack with a shot to win this here at Daytona.
That's him on the outside battling right now for fourth. And I thought he was going to have to give it up, and he stayed right with it. Does it give him the inside down here? He's going to slot past and take not only fourth, he's going to move by Fong and pick up third.
Well, we got another player in there, number 77, Eric Stump. We hadn't said a word about him. He's in there. He's in the tail, back in the back of this group. Can he figure out some way to work his way to the front as they go through that West Bank for the last time?
Now it is just go for it time, and what a draft. Exactly what we'd expect, but now that they're so fanned out, nobody's benefiting. Barnes has the one in the lead as they head down toward the bus stop. Sweeps through. Not sure that's where you want to be coming out of the bus stop, though. We'll see how that plays out.
You can see this thing's moving around as they all try to get back to the throttle and get the biggest drive they can. One rider pushed right up against the wall. Barney's a sitting duck out front in this one, I think. As he looks around over his shoulder, everybody's going to go around him here soon.
Well, these two guys battling it out side by side behind him, that might actually protect him a little bit. He's making this stick, but it's going to be that outside move. What a draft. And let's see, then the big pop to the inside. It is the 33 of Kyle Wyman's leading it to the line, but a sweep move around the outside, and it is going to be, I think, that is going to be O'Hara.
O'Hara, he redeemed himself from last year.
Didn't he, though?
That was the way to do it. And did you see Barney went from first nearly to last in that pack? So that leading it out of the chicane did not pay off this year.
And best way to shake off that little bit of controversy from last year is to beat him clean the first race of the next season. He's done that, and he's done it at Daytona. That's redemption.
That was a great ride by him. And just it's hard to put yourself in just the right spot. I mean, it was just a real crapshoot, like I said, coming to the line, and Tyler just happened to be the guy that got that great draft and was able to pull that off.
And you've got to read what's going on right there when you're in that pack. You've got to look at it and go, all right, where's the best chance going to be here? You know, some of it is absolute luck which way you go, because somebody could move and suddenly you're gone. But, boy, if he was reading it, he chose wisely.
He sure did. Sometimes you just got to take what it's going to give you.
Exactly.
And right there it gave him what he wanted. So congratulations to him. Great run.
33 of Wyman. Kyle Wyman is second in completing the podium. The 50 of Bobby Fong, then Corbino, and then Benjamin Carlson round out your top five. Crevier, Barnes, Narbonne, Wyman, and Gage McAllister complete the top 10. So that is how they finish. And what a great way to start things off here in terms of racing at Daytona International Speedway for this opening round of the GEICO Motorcycle AMA Pro Road Racing Championship, and he is enjoying this moment. Tyler O'Hara, that was well earned, a great, great ride, well judged. Qualified fifth, and just did what he needed to do to make that unfold at this point.
Yeah, what a great class. I tell you, this Harley class and the support by Vance and Hines, they brought this back from the 883 days. It produced a lot of great racers, like the Boston brothers came through. So it's a great stepping stone class for someone who wants to come into the AMA and showcase their talents on the pro level. And it just never fails to produce this kind of racing. Like all the last 2 years, it's just been amazing.
And this is essentially a spec class, for lack of a better term. And as we talked about, these aren't necessarily race prep chassis and the like. Is this the kind of class where what you learn here you can take to the higher levels and make it work?
I think so, Greg.
There's a look at the unofficial results. It's always this close. They keep it very close to the vest and make sure. But O'Hara looks like he's got the win in the opening round over Kyle Wyman, Fong, Corbino, and Carlson rounding out the top five, as I said. Then Crevier, Barnes, the reigning champion, has some work to do in terms of the points. Narbonne, what a lap when he set that fast lap and was right in the hunt. Travis Wyman, the pole sitter, slotting to ninth, tells you how competitive this field was. And 10th, the 51 of Gage McAllister. And he is just enjoying this nice long lap of honor here, the victory lap. So Tyler O'Hara making this one a very, very special one. The Eco Fuel Saver, Scrubblade, Bartels, Harley-Davidson, XR1200, and he gave it a great ride.
He's going to make his way down into the winner's circle in Daytona. That's a special place to be here. All these riders trying to make their way to that spot, that top spot on that in over there, and Tyler's going to be the guy today, and we'll just keep watching this series as the year goes on. It's going to be epic, I'm sure.
That was nice. On his way to Victory Circle, he stopped and said a big thank you to the crew. And, of course, this is very much a team sport. Ryder always gets the accolades, but the guys that work on these bikes, get them set up, fix them after a wreck and the like, that's pretty cool stuff.
It is. You can't do it without those guys, no doubt.
Getting the directions from the AMA officials to head on in to Victory Circle under that very famous bridge, the Rolex Bridge. Makes that left-hand turn, and here he comes, riding his way up into Victory Circle at Daytona. Winner of the first round of the Vance Hines Harley-Davidson Series. And just a superb run, and the celebrations will commence.
That's Josh Chisholm there on the left. Josh is the guy, he's hurt himself. He didn't run today. He was scheduled to run in this race. He's the one that put this team together, so he's got to be happy. Thrilled to get his first team win here at Daytona.
And somewhere down in amongst there, as soon as Tyler get his helmet off, our Greg White will be ready to grab a few words with the winner. I see the mic flag right there. Let's get down to G-Dub.
Thanks, Tyler. I mean, what a way to start 2013. That looked like one of the gnarliest races we've ever seen. How was it?
It was almost like riding singles on a mile. It was pretty hairball, but it was a lot of fun. And I told my dad that I thought I could win it from fifth or sixth, and I think I was fifth or sixth coming out of that first banking there. And this whole team, we got a new sponsor on board, GEICO Fuel Savers, Scrubblade, Bartels Harley-Davidson. Everyone's just working so hard to put this together, and it's great to come out of here with some good points, and it was a lot of fun.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
That was one solid ride. Really, really nice to watch. A lot of fun to call, that's for sure. You get racing like that, it's changing so fast. It's we're behind the eight ball a few times here. But this was the run to the finish. And look where he started. He's tucked up on the outside, made that move, then popped to the outside, Scott.
He followed Kyle Wyman right across and was able to just slip by him at the end. And last year's winner, the 33, he'll still be happy with second. Probably not as happy as he would have been with first, but got great points, and go to the next one.
All right, well, that wraps up our coverage here in Speed 2 of our Pro Vance Hines Harley-Davidson Series. More to come on Speed 2, as we will have our Motorcycle Superstore Super Sport race coming up in just a little bit. For Scott Russell and Greg White, I'm Greg Kramer. Don't go away for too long. We'll be right back on Speed 2 in a bit.